Last weekend, I was in Tuscaloosa, Alabama for the Penn State football game at historic Bryant-Denny Stadium, which hosted its first game way back in 1929. Of course, Penn State has its own historic football venue, Beaver Stadium, that celebrates a significant milestone this week, its 50th birthday. Beaver Stadium literally has its roots in the previous football site, Beaver Field. After the 1959 season, it was dismantled into 700 pieces that were trucked to the other side of campus and reassembled, and 16,000 new seats were added to create Beaver Stadium. The first football game at the new location was played on September 17, 1960, on a rainy afternoon when Penn State shut out Boston University in front of 22,500 fans. The natural grass field has been replaced several times since, on average every 7 years, most recently in 2005 with a blend of Kentucky bluegrass grown on a turf farm in New Jersey. The grass has deep roots for durability and a sand-based sod that minimizes mud when it rains. The field is mowed at least 3 days a week to about an inch in height in a different direction every 5 yards to burn in the alternating pattern of light and dark stripes. A computerized in-ground irrigation system was installed in 2006. Prior to that, the turf was watered, believe it or not, using an above-ground sprinkler. When rain is expected, a tarp is kept on the field until a few hours before kickoff. The field has about a 10-inch crown. That's the slightly raised area that runs down the center and directs runoff toward the sidelines. Last year, there were home games in Beaver Stadium on 4 straight Saturdays in September, something that hadn't happened since 1986. For the last of those games versus Iowa, rain fell from noon onward, about 0.4 inches while the tarp was off. Through that, plus 4 more home games, including one played the day after a freak mid-October snow, the natural turf field held up very well. Here's a look at some of the rainiest games ever played in Beaver Stadium. Longtime fans will remember Navy in 1974, when 0.75 inches turned the field into a sloppy mess and the heavily favored Nittany Lions lost 7-6. No game in Beaver Stadium has been played in as drenching and as cold a rain as when Notre Dame visited in 1985, though a lopsided Penn State win made it easier to take. And then there was Rutgers in 1993. The turf had been replaced a few months earlier but hadn't properly taken root. And as heavy rain fell during the game, clumps of grass were torn and lifted with each play, ruining the field. In the 2 years after that season ended, with a new, heavier sod in place, thousands of small holes were drilled into the turf to a layer of gravel about 1.5 feet below. And those holes were filled with sand to improve the drainage. More holes have been drilled since, and there are now about 250,000 helping to drain the field. By the way, 3 members of the current Penn State coaching staff were also on the field for the first game in Beaver Stadium in 1960. Of course, Joe Paterno is one. Can you name the other two? We'll have the answer a little later in the show. But first, Fred returns with the extended forecast.